was very difficult because I wanted to reach out to her and help her. I wanted someone to help her. I didn't exactly know what was wrong with her, but I knew she was hurting.
There were so many things, like I appeared fine, but there was so much wrong. I felt like everything had been taken away from me at that point.
It was just all of a sudden you're completely messed up and you have no idea why, and everybody around you is sort of asking what's wrong with you.
The spinal cord injury was life-changing for sure. It instantly, you know, changed my world, just turned my world upside down, fundamentally affected pretty much every aspect of my life.
A deep, just sort of dark, chilling feeling went over my body. I actually got goosebumps, I remember. You know, I can't wiggle my toes, and I started crying.
I was epileptic for a while in my kickbox career because I overtrained, and it was mentally and physically just too much for me at some point that I collapsed.
I had so much anxiety to the point where I was going 3-4 days without sleeping.
It's a helpless feeling. You don't understand until you really first recognize that it's happened, that something is different, something's changed in you, both in your child or in a friend.
100% vulnerability and helplessness, just general distrust.
I could even hear like noise that wasn't there. Just constant noise in my head.
She was very fearful, very anxious, always afraid and not knowing what she was afraid of.
Constant thinking, constant overanalyzing, constant feeling insecurities, almost paranoid.
Wanting to die.
Pretty much the toughest, dirtiest jobs that no one else in the military touches, you know. Eliminating targets, various places where, you know, where they're not even supposed to be able to eliminate anyone.
We have a pretty short foot pursuit. He pulls out a gun from somewhere, from his waistband or his pocket, I don't know, and he fires one round under my left armpit. It was a paralyzing round.
One of the major experiences was losing my son. He was a premature baby and he had a lot of complications, so I ended up passing away.
He walked into my kitchen to get a glass of water, and a guy jumped out from behind the refrigerator with a gun stuck to my head, told me if I looked at him that he was going to kill me. Then he put me in handcuffs, made me lie down at gunpoint, proceeded to psychologically torture me.
It was unbelievable. I was hit at night 60 miles an hour head on, and the car caught on fire completely. I was trapped inside and nobody was around, and I was conscious the entire time.
My friend, who had just been certified EMT, came down, did the assessments, got me back to consciousness, and we knew instantly that I had paralyzed myself.
I have the memory of all these faces, of all these corpses floating in my head always. I had that for a long time, you know, and I didn't know what to do with it.
I was lying in the hospital like, how am I going to go on now? How am I going to live my life like this? You know, I had no idea how I was going to get through it.
But what I realized very quickly was I needed to find a way to release all of that emotion out of my physical being.
I've been exposed to it. I've learned to appreciate the effects on the person and the family and what that means, how to deal with it.
I felt like I was carrying this secret about life, about how to navigate out of pain, about how to overcome obstacles, how to find your way to your heart's desire and to a life that's beautiful.
I've come to such a good place after so many years.
It might be hard at first, but it gets easier. And then it becomes just like clockwork. It just starts happening.
You can choose to, you know, be a victim of life, or you can choose to be an advocate of life and go change your circumstances. And, you know, life is what you make of it.
And we're never alone. There's so many people who've been through trauma in their life, whether it's through war or through abuse, or there's stories out there. And if you hear other people's stories, you know you're not alone.